What's up, you guys? Welcome back to episode 26 of our Vault Hunters Let's Play. As you can see from behind me, I kind of did a little bit of building off camera. I pretty much just went ahead and built like a mega factory. I wouldn't really call it a mega factory, but a good sized factory for all of our create stuff. This is where we're going to have the create base at. Up here, I have a windmill that I talked about the last episode. It's an 11 by 11, which I found out is the actual max size. And from there, it's coming down into a clutch. The cool thing about the clutch is you can use redstone to turn it on and off, and it'll actually shut down the entire system. So you can actually set up like different switches if you want to only turn on certain things. But I just have it as like a main power shutoff. It's going down into a vertical gearbox with shafts coming all the way over here. Again, into another vertical gearbox. And this mess of stuff over here is basically what I had to do to get all the gears flowing in the right way. I'm sure there's more efficient ways of doing it. This is just how I found it to work. I have two crushers here. The way this works is it's big old cobblestone generator. This generator right here is just this right here, just in a larger proportion. So I have some mana glass there and one of those trap doors from the block carpentry mod. And basically what it is, I'll show you guys how to turn it on. Over here I have encased chain drives going all the way against here and like a little gear here to kind of continue it onto here. But there's a max limit, I think it's like 12 or 16 blocks or something like that. But I'll add this right here, and it brings the gears all the way. It's a good way to move gears. And that just goes into the back of a mechanical drill. Lava flows down and makes cobblestone. And like I said, same thing over here. They're going onto a conveyor belt, and that's pushing the cobblestone all the way down these lines. You can see right here, this is once this gets full, it'll start going on over here to the gravel side. I'll show you what it looks like over here. It's going to basically ride all the way up there into a chute, which drops it straight down instead of it flying over the place. And after that, once the gravel is full, it's going to go all the way over here, and this brass funnel is going to be the thing to pick it up. Once the gravel is done, it's going to go onto this conveyor belt and do the exact same thing. Cool thing about gravel that I did not know, actually, you can get flint, you can get clay, and sand from this. It's super helpful. I thought I just got sand out of it, but it looks like I get more than I thought. After the sand is filled, it's going to go past the conveyor belt in front of this encased fan that I showed the last episode. This is going to smelt it down into glass. And over here I just have an andesite funnel because I don't need one that transfers a whole bunch of blocks at once. And it'll fill this up. So it's going to take some time before this starts getting filled up. But once it does, then I'll know all of these are completely backfilled. The cool thing over here about that clutch that I was telling you guys about, I have it hooked up to a lever. Once powered on, it turns the entire system off. So if I need to work on something, if I want to add something, just test it out before I actually add it into the system and worry about messing everything else up, I can do that. So I'm super happy about that. I do have a couple plans for today's episode. I want to get to level 75, but before I run a vault, you might be thinking, how am I going to do that? Well, I managed to save up a ton of these booster packs. Didn't even realize I had this many, so I'm going to open up all of those. And then we're going to move over to all of our gear that I've collected over the past episode. Open this stuff up, probably just in a sped up version, that way you don't have to sit there and watch me roll each and every individual thing. And then if we find anything good, I'll definitely showcase that to you guys. Let me know what you guys want me to build with Create next, or if you guys want to see some more of that stuff on camera. It's pretty boring. That took me probably about 3 hours just to set up all of this stuff in here. Because getting the right gear ratios and all that, and to travel the way you wanted to, was just super, super annoying without overstressing the rest of the system. And over here, I have some of those fairy lights just hanging on the wall. Kind of looked like power lines, so I was like, we'll add some of this over here to that. This is just with the camera mod. I had saved that picture to my computer and then uploaded it onto the world. But overall, I'm pretty happy with this build, considering I'm not really a builder. I think it came out pretty decent. I had recorded the entire thing. It looked really, really choppy, so I didn't even bother speeding it up for you guys. But yeah, let's get straight into opening up those booster packs and see if we can hit level 75. Alrighty, from this first batch, let's see what we're getting. So far, a lot of commons. Some rare boots, those aren't too bad actually. Another pair of rare boots. Common hat. That axe wasn't too bad. Ooh! Oh, the slow falling sucks. I hate the slow falling because, check this out. I don't know why, it slows me down in the vault. I might try to get rid of it. I don't know if I'm actually at that stage yet. But that's horrible. I think I need a void orb. What do I need for that? Do I need any? Actually, I might be able to make one of these. I might try to get that done and see if I can get rid of that slow falling, because that is a huge bummer. If it wasn't for that, these would be Omega for sure. So let me put all this gear up and get ready to open up the next batch. Alrighty, let's see. An epic idol, that's good. Quite a bit of levels on there. Might keep that weather immunity. The leech is good. Another epic idol. Getting pretty lucky, honestly. I cannot complain. Okay, so nothing really of value. This is a decent chest plate, but nothing worth switching what I have over. This one also wasn't too bad, but I think my current one's better because it has a fire resistance. So now let's get into the rest of the common loot. Hopefully we get something good, maybe another Omega. Alright, and for the Pandora's box, a couple of hearty apples. Never a bad thing. Now let's check out the loot. Rare idol. We might keep that. For the most part, from what I can see, nothing too crazy. Those are the legs I have are pretty decent. Yeah, so nothing too crazy. This Omega and these idols right there were definitely the best thing that we had. I'm going to make up one of those void orbs and see if we can actually get rid of that slow falling. Hoping we do and doesn't get rid of like that parry or something like that. I'm actually not sure how many you can use. Maybe just one. Hopefully three. If I can use three, I'm going to go ahead and do whatever I got to do to get rid of that. But let me craft it up and we'll be back. Alright, let's hope we get lucky. I went ahead and crafted three of them up. Remove a modifier random from a vault gear. Item when combined in an anvil. Maybe you actually need to have vault. Yeah, I think you need to have vault blacksmith. So we'll hold on to these for later. Not going to use them anytime soon, but maybe down the line we will if I unlock vault blacksmith. I guess we can go ahead and craft up a couple of those crystals and see if we get any good modifiers, mainly on the epic ones. I'm hoping that we do. Let me actually craft about 8 of them. And we'll do this one first. That's not bad. Where's the next epic one at? I like this one. I'm going to probably use this one because that reach is extremely helpful, especially in the vault. These boots, I mean, current boots aren't bad. They are about to break, though. We'll go ahead and try these ones out because it has the most levels on it. Can I craft up a few more of those? I sure can. And 3 levels. Cooldown resistance. So not too bad. That parry is pretty good. I actually have seen it happen a couple times in the vaults, and it's useful when it does, that's for sure. What I'm also going to go ahead and do, I'm not sure if you guys knew this or not, but you can actually put unbreaking on these. I also put some plating on it already. But now it's unbreaking 3 and has 20 plating on it, so that should always be good. It's kind of a bummer we didn't get to level 75, but this next vault will definitely get us there. Probably a couple levels up, actually. I was kind of hoping to get it just so we can get that extra loot. Because I know at 75 you get a different pool table as far as the chests go, and I think you can get ores and stuff like that. That may be level 100, so don't quote me on there. But I guess without further ado, let's hop into a vault. Guys, I have no clue what I was thinking. Obviously, I can get to level 75. I crafted up another crystal, and right as I was about to put it into the portal, I was like, wait, burgers are a thing. So let's eat a couple of these up, get to level 75, and run straight into a level 75 vault. Awesome, level 75. I have a lot of skill points. I don't know what I'm going to spec into yet, but eventually I will choose something. Actually, can I? I can. Okay, yes. Another one of Treasure Hunter and probably even Soul Shard. Now hold off. I'll think about what else I want. But let's hop straight into this vault. And alrighty, here we go. Let's hope we get something decent. Oh, locked, gilded, and lucky. But the good thing is, it's only 3 obelisks, so I should definitely be able to get this one done. Let's hope so anyways, because I would hate to lose all of my loot. I'll check that an extra minute, so that's not bad. Hopefully that helps out. Okay guys, right there, you can see there's a pillager. That is one of the new mobs that spawn at level 75. Kind of worries me because they do hit hard. Thankfully that one was not too much of a challenge. And we also got our first obelisk. So that's going to be good. Two more after this. Thank you. Okay, nice. Obelisk number two. Alright, we did find the last obelisk. I'm gonna go ahead and fight the boss, even though I have a little extra time. Don't know how long this is gonna take. Alrighty, that took a little longer than I expected, but we did get it done. So now it's time to head back to the base and see what kind of loot we got. Alrighty, we are back. Let's check it out. Ooh, a notch apple. That's good. A couple of pieces of unidentified gear. I'm going to go ahead and roll all of this because I did get quite a bit of stuff and a lot of ores as well. But I'll roll all of this stuff off camera. If I get anything good, I'll come back. I did clear out my danks, so let's see. 18 volt diamonds. Okay, that's great. 43 star essence. And 12 catalyst fragments, because the next mod that I do want to unlock is going to actually be the Volt Blacksmith, just so I can use those void orbs and hopefully get rid of that slow falling. We'll see. Alrighty, and this is all the ores I got. You can see now you do get ores, like I stated. I'm going to have to make a dank or upgrade one of my current danks so I can store all of these, because it's definitely clogged up my inventory. And then I did get an echo gem, which is nice, and a sword that I forgot to roll. I think we got, yeah, quite a bit of trader cores, so that's great. And I might actually have to redo this entire dank because it's not picking up some of that volt gear that I'm getting. I crafted up a couple pogs. Now let's go ahead and get these danks. I'm going to go ahead and upgrade it to a tier 3 just so I have room for all the ores. Not only those ores, also the volt ores, so that's going to help out with looting. Alrighty, check it out. I took all the ores out of my system, all of the volt ores, and I actually had one of each, which is great. So we're going to go ahead and filter all of these so that way this picks it up, and I have one extra slot, so no telling what I might add there. If I find another ore, I'll add it there for sure, like an echo ore. I know I could put that there. Also, I think I'm going to go ahead and spec into execute precision and go ahead and max this out, since I do have the extra skill points. That's going to definitely help out when killing the bosses, because they're getting a lot tougher now. Alright, with that last vault being such a success, I went in and cleared out all of my tanks once again, and let's just get straight into another vault. Easy, lucky, plentiful journey. That'd be nice if we can actually get our first artifact. But we'll see. We were not able to defeat it. Sorry, I cleared out my inventory. We got pretty close, but just wasn't able to get it. Let's head back to the base and see what kind of loot we got. Level 79. We're getting pretty close to that level 80 mark. So for loot, you can see here, a couple of unidentified items. Not very many volt diamonds or star essence. A couple of catalyst fragments. That's not bad. And that's pretty much all. I did get a mod box. I want to go ahead and open that. See what we got. What is that? It's RF. Okay, that's cool. It's a little storage module. Not bad, not bad. Thank you. you can definitely tell that that execute puts in work. We got the boss down to about half HP, and it did the rest for me. Here is that loot we got from those two Volt runs. Here's that first one. A lot of Volt gear. 6 Volt diamonds, 19 star essence. And I forget that we get these Volt runes now, so that's great. And the second run was the good one. 21 Volt diamonds, 27 star essence, and another Volt rune, and a ton of gear. I'm going to open all this off camera. If I find anything crazy, I'll come back to you guys. And then a couple little traders. I did go ahead and make another cryo chamber, and we got a ton of these Pandora's boxes, so I'll probably open those up in a time lapse. But for now, I'm going to open up this gear and come back if we find anything. Here's all the gear we got. Nothing really too crazy. Decent little helmet, but my current Omega is a lot better than that. But other than that, really nothing of value that I can personally use at this moment. I am starting to realize we are getting a little bit outskilled, but that's going to be fun. It's just part of the challenge. This is from that last set that I opened a while back. But yeah, now it's time for the Pandora's boxes. Alright, quite a bit of things. The mod box is great. Let's get a Terror Shatterer. What is that? Diamond upgrade. That's not bad, though. Oh, wrong one. I forgot I switched those around. Because now I can put my danks there. And then some more gear. So I'll open all that and be back. Yeah, again, nothing crazy on this gear. So that's fine. I do want to show y'all what I've been working on. So you can see over here, my Botania setup's a bit different. I'm just getting it all set up for next episode. Got pretty much everything I'm going to need for that Terror Shatterer, a couple mana diamonds. The only thing I'm missing out on is the mana. So off camera, I'm going to probably just build a little station, probably move this somewhere, and get everything set up in the foundation ready for when we craft that Terror Shatterer next episode. I made a lot more Endoflames, and what I like about this setup is, let me see, do I have my vanilla loot on me? I do. So what I do is come over here, we grab some coal, and I'll show you how cool this is. It's cool to me anyways. And what I actually like about it also is you can actually change the color of these with some lenses. I'm not going to do that, but you obviously could. So I just put, I want to make an automated system that constantly feeds this, but I don't know. It's kind of complex for the mods I have now. But yeah, that just looks dope, I think. That looks pretty neat. And then it goes into this mana splitter, which divides it evenly in between all four mana pools. This one's always going to have a little more because it had some more before I added those ones. Also, I did add, I was able to speed this up just a hair, and it's making this go a lot quicker. So you can see already, since I've been recording this episode, this is already cool. And I think the gravel is just about, I'm shifting because my magnet will pick all this up. Yeah, gravel is getting there, and then it's going to start filling up these items, and we'll be pretty good on that. Also, I worked on this crystal. I got super lucky, luckier and lucky. Cannot find Gilded Hoarder or anything like that, so we just may save this in case we find some keys or something like that. I know I'm quite a bit off. I think I only have like 2 of them. But still, once we do get one eventually, it'll basically be Omega. Yeah, I only got 2 key pieces right now, so I want to get quite a bit of them. Speaking of that, ooh, an artifact. How many do I have? Let's gamble. Bitter Limit. Okay, well, I got it at a discount, so that's not bad. Could have been better, like a Pog or something like that, but not going to complain. That is going to probably do it for today's episode. I know it's going to be on the shorter side, like a lot shorter side. But this is pretty much all I had time to record. It is the weekend for me now, and I do have the next 2 days off, so I'm glad about that. So I do plan on getting at least 2 videos out, one Saturday and one Sunday. Next episode is going to be all about Botania. So if y'all want to see that, be sure to stop by. I would appreciate it. Also, leave a like and comment. Also, subscribe if you're not. I'd really do appreciate that. I do hope you guys are having a great day, and God bless you guys. Bye-bye.